Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and this episode is about a voice scrambling device for secure communications from the 90s that, strangely, as you will realize on your own, was quite popular. I'm talking about the ACS-2 from REI, Research Electronics Incorporated, based in Allgood, Tennessee. ACS-2 was advertised as the Scrambler. Unfortunately, I don't have the original package, but you can see it in some of the photos over here. It's worth noting that its price back then was a couple of hundreds of dollars, which is also the average price that you can find it today. The difference is that today people buy it for its collectible value rather than the security that it provides. Each package had only one device, since the Scrambler is able to provide scrambled communications between two or more devices. On the side of the package, we can find a brief description of how the Scrambler works. The Scrambler protects your sensitive communication between two or more users by electronically converting normal, clear speech to unintelligible scrambled speech. The properly coded matching unit then reconstructs the scrambled speech back to the clear speech. The Scrambler protects the entire communication link, and it's followed by a list of examples of what it protects us from. So this device was advertised as a CompSec system, that is, communication security. And we can find a lot of references about it in various sources, including the Crypto Museum, where it has a pretty complete documentation of the Scrambler. You can also see an advertisement from December 1994 at the Popular Mechanics magazine in a page titled "Who is listening to your private calls?" as well as books such as The Spy, Discover the World of Espionage from the Early Spy Masters to the Electronic Surveillance of Today from 1996, that mentions it under the section for counter-espionage. Now, on the back side of the package, it says that the device allows for 13,122 user-selectable codes. How this is done is by tweaking those switches that are over the battery compartment, which have three different positions. You can better see those switches over here. As you can see, the Scrambler works with a single 9-volt battery, and in order to authenticate two or more devices, you have to configure the switches in order to have the same code. For my demonstration over here, I have configured two Scrambler devices with all of the switches in the top position. This is important because otherwise the devices wouldn't be able to authenticate to each other. Now, if we put that to the side, you can see that the Scrambler has a strap. This is an adjustable strap, that how it works is that you pass the phone so it sits on top of it, like the microphone on the speaker. Also, the strap is adjustable in height, but also the speaker and the microphone are adjustable to have as perfect fit as possible, regardless of the phone that's being used. The Scrambler has no power on button. If you press the clear button that you see over here, what's going to happen is that the device will boot up, it will do a battery check, and then just transmit whatever you are seeing in clear mode. You can see it right here. In this mode, the device is not doing anything apart from passing what it receives to the line. Still, we can adjust the volume or even mute the microphone if we wanted to. However, this is the recommended test operation to verify that the Scrambler works as expected. Now, if we are talking with two or more people that have Scramblers, let's also power this on, we can do something else, which is sync them and have the scrambled mode on. This can be done by pressing the scramble button. And when I press this, what is going to happen is that the device I'm pressing the button on will transmit a code which is based on the switches that we set previously, and that will authenticate it to the other device and they can begin the scrambled communication. Let's see that. So now we'll turn them off to avoid having this noise. What you just heard, the authentication tone, is also the biggest design flaw of this device. The authentication tone is configured based on the code that we set previously on the devices. However, this is not affecting the inversion frequency. The inversion frequency is the frequency used to scramble the voice communication, and this remains the same. So, regardless of the code that we set, if a signals intelligence analyst discovers the inversion frequency, they can easily decode the whole communication. For this reason, the ACS-2 Scrambler is more of a device for security through obscurity, as even with minimal technical expertise, someone can decode the scrambled communication. Now that you have this understanding, let's do it one more time. We are enabling both devices in clear mode. They are doing the battery test, they are in clear mode. And now let's enable the scrambling from the other device. Okay, and turn them off again. Okay, I'm certain that you are all curious to hear how the scrambled communications sound like. So, here is an example. Did you manage to decode this? If yes, then please share it in the comments below. I hope that you like the presentation of the REI ACS-2, the Scrambler, and understand why it doesn't really provide actual ComSec, just a false sense of security. Once again, thank you for watching the Spy Collection, and as always, remember, nothing is as it seems.